doing. This series follows the pattern of their first round against Portland when they won 4 straight games after dropping the series opener. But as we mentioned earlier, Houston feels very confident heading into a pivotal game 3 tonight. According to Fox Bet, the Lakers are a 5-point favorite to win tonight and regain momentum in the series. So, Shannon, will L.A. cover the 5 points?
I'm expecting a close one. I'm thinking something like 123, 118, something like that.
Five.
I'm going right on the bus. But we're going to get this dub. I'm going to come in here with something special for you tomorrow.
You don't have real courage of your conviction on this.
LeBron get a triple dub.
Really?
Yep.
Well, then they should win by more than 5.
Nah.
Come on.
No. The Rockets shoot too many threes. Well, they could always be
the bucket. You went Conor McGregor on the Rockets. You said that little tiny people with little tiny legs. Didn't you say that?
Yep. Little
well, then how can they not cover tonight?
They shoot a bunch of threes.
Give me 5 points for one case of Diet Mountain Dew.
You know what, Skip? Since it's you, I give you 4.
4?
4.
Why would you be afraid of 5?
Skip, they shooting 53s. They make 20 of them. It's going to be a ball game.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you're afraid of that?
I give you 4. Yeah, I'm afraid of the 3.
Take the 5 right here, 4. Right now.
Fox Bet says 4.
I got the Rockets winning the game.
Fox Bet says 4.
Fox Bet says 4?
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was 5.
Mm-mm.
Also, it's being bet down?
Yep.
Okay, I'll take 4 right
okay,
now.
Deal.
Is that true about Fox Bet?
Yeah, I think so.
You think so? what are we talking about?
It's for sure 5. Shannon, you can't
appreciate
lie.
That. Got the band, Skip.
Wait, no, I got lied to.
It's 5.
I just got duped.
I misspoke the truth.
You said 4?
You misspoke the truth?
Yeah, it was disinformation.
It's a lie.
It's disinformation. Perception and the general reception of these demonstrations have changed over the last... George Floyd happened. Breonna Taylor happened. Yep. Jacob Blake happened. And I think that changed the perception and the reception of these protests, these demonstrations. And so I don't think he had to skip the days of the athlete keeping their opinion to themselves mm-hmm. and keeping these issues to themselves. That's over. The cat's out of the bag now, or the toothpaste out of the tube. Whatever term cliche you want to use, Skip,
yep.
those days are over now. And I think the thing is for me is for Jerry... After being silent for 109 days, he tried. Skip, he tried. Well, we're going to handle this thing with grace, and I can see us doing something like what we did in Arizona.
He wanted to do the pre-anthem.
Right. He tried. But the players weren't going for it. Mm-hmm. And I think the thing is that they see and they saw what the NBA did, and they prepared. I think they prepared for this. They knew this was coming. I also report that all the end zone will be painted in racism. It's going to be interesting to see because normally you see Dallas and you see Cowboys or you see Cowboys in the end zone. And now all of a sudden, because it's going to be the equal to Black Lives Matter on the basketball court.
Yeah.
So I think Jerry got boxed in. This is not where he wanted to be, Skip, but I don't believe he had a choice in this matter considering the climate that's going on in America and what's going on with this team.
Would Jerry insist that end racism is in blue and white? I don't know. He might.
I think they might want to paint it in white and black. I don't know how they're going
to
do it, Skip.
I would assume that would be the way to go. Look, I was shocked by this because I just know Jerry Jones.
Yes.
I was pleasantly shocked.
Mm-hmm.
This is a seismic shift by a 77-year-old man who will be the first to tell you, I'm God and country, my hands over my heart,
right.
and my players will have their toes on the line.
That's what he said.
And all of a sudden, he thawed, and he mellowed, and then he melted. And he said, the rising tide is upon me.
Yeah.
I cannot fight it anymore.
No, you couldn't.
It's time for me to do... I think he believes in his heart of hearts, it's time for me to do the right thing. He kept using that word grace. He used it again on a show today. I'm going to do this with grace. But he also plunged and went so far as to say, I recognize the ability of the Cowboys to use the visibility and interest we have to support those players. They need help. It's time for us to help them. And he just flat out declared there will be no angst between me and the players. And he said, this was like a decree. And no angst between me and the fans. So he's telling the fans, just sit back and watch it
right.
and accept it. No matter what you think, because this is nothing against the flag. This is their form of protesting that we've all come to understand. This is the way it should be.
Jerry. Mm-hmm. Call Ted Cruz, mm-hmm. call Cornyn, those senators, from Texas, get on the phone and call Agreed. President Trump.
Yep.
With that visibility, with that power.
By the way, I think President Trump is going to call him today to say, what are you doing?
We get that, and the players appreciate your support.
Yeah.
But the players have made it abundantly clear. That's what the NBA said. We appreciate the money that you're giving us, but we need that influence, those connections that you have to really bring about change. Jerry, that's what they want you. That's what, Jerry, if you don't give a dollar, but if you pick up that phone and call Ted Cruz, if you call Tom Corn, I think it's Corn in his last, the senator from Texas, and you call those guys.
Yep.
That's what they really appreciate that. Dak might even, cut your deal. Dak might be willing to cut your deal.
He might.
Might be willing to do that.
And yet it was Dak who dug in about 5 days ago and said, you know what? We've heard Mr. Jones talk about grace and grace and grace, but now it's time to act.
Yeah, you heard me. Yeah. When someone says it like that, we heard what you said.
Yeah.
That means they like, we're not listening.
We heard it. He said it very politely.
He did.
But
he did.
Made it very
he said
strong.
Mr. Jones and everything.
Yeah,
think about it, Skip. Everybody called him Jerry. Nobody calls him Mr. Jones.
No.
I've never been around anybody that call him Mr. Jones.
No.
Even his kids and grandkids call him Jerry.
They do.
I've never thought about him as Mr. Jones. That is interesting. Jerry to everyone.
He don't like you to call him
Guys,
Mr. Jones.
All right. LeBron's Lakers, hours away from that pivotal game. Will it be a blowout?
In the bag.
The bubble. Is that what we're about to see? Stick around.